Dr. Sella here, and I had a client ask me about this, and basically the answer to this question is if you line up in the flex formation and want to run triple option, basically what happens if they give you a rule of two? So number one's a defender touching the tackle, and then you've got a corner that's within 5 yards of the receiver. He's like, well, we put him in the count, right? And I said, well, yeah, you put him in the count if he's that close to fold in and tackle the quarterback. So now you've got a rule of two. So what this means is you're going to have a double load scheme. Very rare that this would happen. Now, obviously, coaches, the answer is you want to run off tackle or outside, but let's say they're actually foolish enough to put number one in the B back. So the first thing you do is you run zone dive. So you're going to triple team the three technique. The A-back wedges with the tackle. You hand the ball off. If this guy is stupid enough to come into the wedge, which in high school you never know, he might be, then you start reading it because who cares? Because at that point, you're going to be off tackle or outside anyway. So here's what's going to happen. You're going to have the receiver and the A-back are both going to load. The reason why is because, well, he can't arc because then he's blocking the pitch key. So he'll block. Let's say you get a bare stack here. He'll block the stacked backer. And if, let's say he, I don't know, maybe they brought him into the A gap and brought him through. I don't know how you can really do that, but in high school, who knows? Well, then he'd end up on the safety, and one of them will end up on the mic to the safety. So basically what happens is, in this situation is, there's going to be a deuce call. The guard and tackle are going to double the three. The center's going to veer play side on the deuce call. He has the mic to the free safety. So basically, the receiver, the A-back, and the center have the two backers to the safety. So the center's going to veer play side, and if he stays in his gap, he'll block the mic. Otherwise, he'll change the safety. He'll block the stacked backer, and then he'll end up on the mic to the free safety. So if the mic can get over the top of that block, good luck with that. A-back will block the mic. I'm saying things like this because this is kind of insane to some point, because if they're going to put eight people in the tackle box, you got to go off tackle or outside. Paul Johnson would tell you that if you got a TNT alignment, the dive's canceled. It becomes a two-way option from there. But anyway, if they're foolish enough to put number one in the B back after you run zone dive, this is what you would do. So you got the receiver on the stack back, you got the A back has the mic to the free safety, a deuce, meaning the center goes play side. He gets his left knee from the mic to the three safety, and they scoop the backside. Guard sprints his belly button to the hip of the center. Tackle sprints his belly button to the hip of the guard. Backside receiver cuts off. Okay. Then you got your triple option from there. Quarterback takes the snap, jumps to the play side A gap, points the ball. B-back sprints with the ball, sprints with the play side hip of the tackle because of the deuce call, gets vertical and scores. Number one takes the B. Remember, the whole reason you're running it is because number one is taking the B back. Quarterback's going to replace him and score. And then if number two is actually dumb enough to fold in on the quarterback, quarterback will stop his feet, flick the ball to the A-back coming around, and congratulations, there's nobody left. They run out of people. So that's how you'd run flex triple versus a rule of two. That's how you would do it. Coaches, if you want to win more games in 2022, give me a call. My number is on the thumbnail of this video. So is my website. We'll talk later.